The Compositing Actions Magic Pack has been redeveloped into version 2 to make it even easier for you to composite. So I'll take you through the new settings. First of all, you need to choose your layer. Now, this can be now. It can be a PNG, it can be a smart object, it can also have a mask. This will work with any of your settings. So the first thing that you want to do is choose one of your action options here. Let's start with the shape shadow. So if we click on that, you can see straight away it creates the shape shadow based on your PNG or your cutout file, and then you can edit it as you need to. The other awesome thing about this is it will drop it down below the feet, so there's a lot less moving that needs to happen. Now you can further soften, blend, and puppet warp your shadow. When you've created the shape shadow, you might then want to transform. So the first thing that you want to do is grab the corners to match the perspective. Now this is different for every scene, and this is why this can't be built into the action, because it's dependent on your scene and your background and the perspective of it. But once you've got it close, double click. The next thing that you want to do is actually move those legs to match up. So you can use puppet warp for this. If you click on puppet warp, lock down the top area as you need to, and probably at the top of the legs as well. And just grab the tips of the feet and move them underneath the foot as you need to. So puppet warp gives you a little more control over the individual areas. We'll move that foot up under there and under there. Now you can also use the mask and paint where you need to tidy it up. As I said, every shadow is different. Click tick to lock that down. Now you might want to fade out that top area there. So you can do that directly on the shadow. But if you want a little more control, I recommend grouping the shadow, putting it into the group, and creating a mask on the group. This just means that you can go back and forth without destroying your shadow. So I turn the flow down and just paint off the top area there so that it fades, because the further away a shadow gets, the more faded it is. So you can do that manually, or you can just leave the shadow as is. You can also obviously change the opacity to match your scene. Check out other shadows in the scene to try and match it. Now that we've got the shadow there, the shape shadow, the next thing we want to do is add a contact shadow. Now I've made this easier with version 2. You don't have to paint it in yourself at all. Just make sure that you've got your element selected that you want to add the shadow to. Click on contact shadow. And you will see it creates a contact shadow all the way around your subject. Now what you want to do is obviously paint off the area that does not need the shadow. So you only need the shadow for this one on the bottom of the feet, but you might have another object against a wall that you do actually need a shadow all the way around. So just paint off with your brush. The shadow is only around the edge, so you can just go around the edge very, very quickly. And leave that contact shadow down under the feet. Very, very easy, and it's perfect. It's exactly around the edge of the feet in the right shape. So when that's done, click back on your subject. You want to add some rim light now. Again, I've made this easier, so click on rim light. And then paint on the areas you don't want. So you can see the rim light is going all around the edge of our dingo here. Now we want to just paint off the areas that are not needed as much. So definitely at the back of the dingo there, just underneath a little bit. We don't want as much rim light there, the back there. So work out where the light's shining, where it's not shining, and pop your rim light around the edges where it's needed. So that creates a very, very simple and quick rim light around the edge of your dingo. If you need to paint a little bit more back, you can click on the X and just paint manually around any areas that you want to emphasize. So you've still got full control around all of the edges, but it just makes it much, much quicker to do. All right, so next you want to perhaps add some shading. So this one, again, I've made it easier. Click on shading and then mask off the areas you don't want. You can turn down the opacity as well. So we've got a backlit scene. I'm going to zoom back on this. We're going to turn the shading down on our dingo here. Just want it subtle. So if I click on and off, and where that light is coming on the front there, I don't really want any shading. So I'm going to paint it off here, the front of the dingo, and leave a little more shading on the back of the dingo there. So again, it's completely dependent on your particular scene and your light. If we go now to color toning, that's the same as before. It will take in all the colors of your scene and it will tone the dingo or whatever subject that you've got. If it comes up with the create clipping mask is not available, just press continue. That's only because there are already some elements clipped. So now you can see that makes a huge difference in the color matching the scene. Blend is another aspect that will help blend it together. So click back on your dingo, click on blend. Now it's a subtle approach, but what happens is it helps to blend the subject into the scene more. Before it was there, you would have found that it was a little bit too sharp and a little bit too solid. So now we've brought more atmosphere into the dingo so it matches the scene as well. Finally, light spill. So if we click on light spill, again, if it says this, don't worry about it, just press continue and paint off any areas that you don't want the light spill. So you can see there's a nice lot of light spill coming across the top of the dingo there. We can paint it off the bottom when we don't need it, but you know, it makes it a whole lot easier to blend it in. So we can turn that down as well. So now we've got our dingo completely composited into the scene just with the click of a few buttons. Really hope this helps you guys in speeding up your workflow.